This is Kunkasis for IFL TV. We're at the Space here in Dubai for the Jingle Bell Show. I'm joined by Lawrence Accoli. Long time, not no speak, because we speak, obviously. But, yeah, how are you, first of all?
Yeah, no, I'm good. Just happy to be here. Nice event. I'm proud of Nova Sports Napa and that for the work that they've been putting in, so it's good to see.
Yeah, I think we're about halfway through the card at the moment. Obviously, we know about the space here. There's probably cars that you didn't even know existed that are here.
Yeah, no, this is like their version of like York Hall, a little bit maybe more fancy and stuff. But yeah, it's where all the boxing happens here, really. If it's not going to be like the Coca-Cola Arena or something like that, then this is a good venue for it.
Shout out to Napa for putting this event on tonight, and shout out to Napa for the hospitality. Right, what's going on with you, Lawrence? What's happening?
Nothing, just here, chilling, ticking over, waiting to get back out. I think I'm back out in February, so just waiting on that.
Okay. You're kind of direct and indirect sometimes in questioning, so I'll just see how this kind of goes. But are you going to be in Bournemouth next week?
What is that? The maybe.
On a Sunday.
Maybe. It'll be good to go down and support the event.
For you though, is that your immediate focus now, to kind of put a wrong right in your perspective with Billum Smith? Is that what's on your mind?
Oh, it's 50-50. I mean, it's 50-50. Like right now, obviously the most important stuff to me is stuff like the birth of my firstborn boy, stuff like that. So I'm focusing on that kind of stuff, and it all ties in around the same time. But outside of that, we'll see what 2024 has in store.
What have you learned about yourself over the last 5-6 months? What have you learned?
Oh, nothing new. Do you know what I mean? Nothing new, like, really, if I'm honest. Nothing new. I don't know. What do you mean?
I'm just saying, like, obviously, the situation you was kind of presented with for the first time in your career, I'm just saying, have you learned anything off the back of that?
Oh, yeah, of course. Like, yeah. Losing's never fun. Losing's never nice. Just in terms of, you know what, with that one, I think the most important thing that I realised is that, you know, for a long time, as long as you win, it doesn't matter. After losing, it's like, you know what, in terms of what I wanted out of boxing, in terms of winning a world title, getting financially secure within myself, converting the boxing money into business money, yeah, like, it's all done. So now it's kind of like, I'm more interested in just fulfilling, like, stuff for myself. And in terms of boxing, being... I don't know, you know what it is, because now my future kids are going to all look, see, Lawrence won the world title, lost, oh, he holds a bit, you know, so I kind of want to have the next chapter, like, a lot more explosive, whatever happens, is the worst thing that can happen is happening, losing, so now I just want to go out there and enjoy myself.
It was a shout almost from when you turned pro. The question was always kind of, when are you moving out, from your early kind of cruiserweight days, but where does that kind of play in at the moment in your kind of career path moving forward for you to be in heavyweight? Because you move to heavyweight, it's like, God, take your pick of the fights that you could be in with.
That's why I say it's 50-50, because obviously there's a part of me, oh, right and wrong, blah, blah, blah. But Chris, although I expect him to win, he can lose the next fight. Imagine you could get caught. I don't really focus too much on, like, Chris, for example. It's more on myself and what I can do. Do you get where I'm coming from? Whether that's at cruiserweight, whether that's at heavyweight, it doesn't really matter to me. I'm just going to go and enjoy myself.
All right. Your ideal first fight heavyweight, who is it?
I don't know yet. It depends.
Dream big. Let's go. Come on.
You said first fight, so I'm just... I don't know, you know. That's a good question.
All right. No. All right. Your introduction into heavyweight, okay. We know how that'll go, how that'll be matched, which is understandable. But kind of, who's your fighter heavyweight you're thinking right now on the scene now? Do you know what? Let me test myself against that guy heavyweight.
There's not really any that I'm gunning for, none that I'm not gunning for. It just is what it is. Obviously, I managed to win a world title at cruiserweight. If I move up to heavyweight, I'd like to attempt to do the same there. So whatever the landscape looks like after Usyk and Fury fight, that's what the landscape looks like. And I think, personally, as much as I will still make cruiserweight if I have to right or wrong, if there is opportunity at heavyweight, I think it's going to be a lot better for me physically anyway, because I walk around, I don't want to say what I walk around, but I walk around heavy, and I think that I feel my best when I'm actually a little bit heavier anyway, so we'll see how stuff goes.
I was right what I said, indirect,
it's
direct.
True. No, it's true. It is, because I'm still trying to figure it out, if that makes sense.
I get that. This is I get the phase you're in your career at the moment.
So like I said, of course there's options, like cruiserweight there's options, heavyweight there's definitely options, so it just depends on how stuff works out over the next week or so.
But just in general, we can expect to see you in action at some point, I'm assuming, at the first part of 2024.
Yeah, I'd say February, definitely. Yeah. Obviously, the boy will be born in the next week or two. And then by February, I'll be back ready to have a fight.
Okay, Lawrence Coley, thank you very much for talking to IFL TV. Have you got anything else you'd like to add before we finish?
No, just thank you for coming out, showing support to Napa. And we're just here enjoying ourselves.
Yeah, it's mad. Amir Khan over there. Thank you very
Yes.
Look at the size difference.
Oh. Massive, yeah. Big, isn't it? Come see me.
See you.
I know. Look, the champ is here, man.
The champ is here.
You know what? I thought you were tall, but he's taller than you, bro.
Same.
He's a professional athlete, so we can lose this argument right now.
Yeah, we were together in Bahrain.
Yeah, how was Bahrain?
Really
Step
good,
in a sec, because they can't really see you there.
It's too big, man. It's taking all the space.
Try and move it down. But Bahrain was good, yeah?
Yeah, no, Bahrain was all right. It was good, man. It was all right, innit? Yeah, good boxing. I mean, I think it's amazing when fighters from different generations, like, together, you can help each other, you can talk to each other about, give advice and stuff. I think it's amazing. You know, I've been there, I've done it, I've gone through it all. What the champ's going through now, what Lawrence is going through, and I think that sometimes sharing a few small words can take you a long way.
Okay, we can't really see you on that.
There he is.
Oh, Napa, bring Napa in, bring Napa in. Napa, get in the middle there, because we can't really see. Look, there's your screen now. Look, can you see the screen now? Look. Get in there. Wait. Hold on, stay there.
Like,
get in a bit more. Yeah, Vada, check on Napa anyway. What's going on? Good event. What?
I'll pass any Vada. Easy.
Oh, mate, you're all right, okay. Woo. You got the stars here, you got a Coley here, Amir Khan here, John O'Carroll's here somewhere.
You got Big Z here as well. Have you met Big Z?
Z!
I don't know what's going on. Pleased with the way the show's gone?
Yeah, I'm so happy everyone came out and showed me some love. And I just wanted to put on a show in Dubai because obviously I live here and there's so many boxers that don't get a chance to fight, that become inactive. And not everyone, I can convince Frank Smith or the team to fight in the UK. So I thought let's do some shows over here to give some people opportunities to fight.
Absolutely. Yeah, listen, you've obviously been around this scene for quite some years now, and obviously there are fighters out here that kind of, unless you're putting them on shows, fighters that you're involved with, they're not going to get out.
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. So I want to do this more and often so everyone gets a chance to show the skills they got.
No worries. Well, listen, appreciate your hospitality here. The space, a wonderful venue. I'm going to drive one of them orange Rolls Royces out of here tonight. I'll probably get about 30 seconds up the road. Anyway, have you got anything else you'd like to add?
No, there'll be more shows next year. If you're inactive, you want some fights, hit me up. I'll get you fighting.
Napa, thank you very much, and good luck with the rest of the night.